Pinta Village.
Good to see you.
Thank you.
George Adamson, who's the president.
Thank you.
Eugene Alexandro.
Hello there.
Sir, right here.
Thank you. Hello. Nice to see you.
Hello there.
I'm Dr. Petrov.
Well.
Sir, look right here, sir. Thank you.
Nice to see you.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Nice to see you.
Hi, Gene Yardinsky. Thank you.
Nice to see you.
My name is Mila Foster.
Father Victor Patel. Yes, I should see you. Nice to see you.
See you? Okay.
Okay, Pete, you want to help us here before we bring the stills?
Still photographers. Media in here for this picture.
Okay, grab the stills in now.
Don't forget to smile.
One moment, sir.
I'm honored by all of you.
Mr. President, on behalf of the all Orthodox Christians and Russian Americans and many others, I'd like to present you this plaque for this year in the millennium of Christianity. And it's the historic event because people in the Soviet Union actually cannot do it. And they cannot give anybody a present of this nature in the Soviet Union, because you know as well as you do that they have no rights, no human rights. And this is on behalf of all the Orthodox Christians who really never had a chance to do it. So this is this spirit, we're giving it to you, and we're wishing you many years, and we wish that you continue to work for this country, continue to do a good job, continue, share your experiences with the future leaders of this country and the world.
Thank you very much. I want you to know that I'm greatly honored. I appreciate this, and the whole matter of religious freedom is very high on the agenda tonight. Every meeting with the General Secretary, you had some meetings. I can't help but wonder if he accepts doesn't realize how strange it is that they can be celebrating the millennium of Christianity in their country at the same time that they won't allow their people now to practice Christianity.
Well, in his book he wrote that there was a sentence that says that in the middle of the 70s, something happened. He says, something happened. Now this is amazing for a materialist to say that something happened and the country just went down. So whatever that something is, he can't say, or we can't.
Yeah, I've been saying a lot of prayers that the attitude that he has shown in so many things, the progress that we've made, including in the area of human rights, that he is, my prayer is that he is truly motivated and intends to pursue this. I know that he's running into great opposition from some of the diehards in his own government.
Like 90%.
But the people seem to be catching up and going with it. Well,
got a few pretty familiar good faces coming this way. Yeah.
Yeah. I know you're going to get sick of this.
What's your name,
Jim? I don't think we've seen one another for 5 minutes.
Hi, how are you?
Good.
Hi, I'm Sandy Winfield.
Nice to see you.
Hi, Janine Chase.
Hello there.
Hi, I'm Carrie Gagan. Well, it's nice to meet you.
Nice to see you.
Excuse me. Hi, Carrie Douglas. Nice meeting you.
Nice to meet you.
Hi, I'm Selena Jackson.
Hi.
Hello.
Hello.
I'm Sherry Seaman.
Nice to see you.
You too.
Hello there. Is Mark coming in?
Oh, I'm sorry. It's already starting. Hi, Mr. President. Thank you.
Well, all right.
Well, thank you all. You're going to like it here in Los Angeles.
Mark, stop it. Slug in the column. Keep him in line.
Forward just a little bit.
What about the sun?
Yeah, that's what I'm trying to get up.
Come forward, Daphne. Yeah, you guys come forward. There. Okay, that's good. And squeeze in close.
What's the other thing?
Should I just put my hand up and block?
Why do the grapes on me? Does it look so much better? You come forward just another
there.
Yeah.
I'll break it out. Then you're totally great, Papa Bear.
Move a little closer.
It's keeping up. Thanks.
Big star. It was always clear over there. Finally, one day I said to him, I said, Fred, you're a big star. I said, what? Are you always over there instead of in the middle? He said, nobody reads the entire caption, but they always start reading from left to right. I figured that's a pretty good idea. Well, it's much longer, is it?
Yeah, a couple days.
That's why we wanted to do the picture day, Mr. President, because some of the people start to leave on the beginning of January, so January 2nd, in fact, so we'll all be in place when you get out there.
You mean it's all good to be open by then? Don't have to wait till the
21st
of
January? Some people have to be out there to wait for some of the equipment, furniture, and things that are coming in, so it should be all set.
By golly, Fred, you haven't gotten the pictures off of here yet, and you haven't got the cartoons out of it. You know,
we're working on that.
But all of this stuff over here is mine. Hidden talents. See the little silver bust there of Benjamin Franklin? Chief Justice Warren Burger made that.
Oh, really? Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
Wow.
One day, it was a gift. Made it originally in bronze and decided to make one that way. Us. Now the saddles will all be in the office until the library is built. That is the history of the Western saddle. And our artist is done, beginning with a 1540 Italian war saddle. And then he started how it developed in the saddle, even Indian ones. So there's a dozen of them. And they belong to
Vandenberg?
You know what the years behind?
Vandenberg. Vandenberg.
But he loaned them to me. And now he promised to perpetuate it, but that means it goes by way of the office and then the library. There he is. Isn't it, you know, I've told a few of you here that as the years go on, there are three things that you begin to notice that happen to me. the first one is you begin to forget things. And I can't remember the other
I think we better let you get back to work.
Well.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you. Merry Christmas.
See you all. It's California.
That's right.
You want it, you yes. want to insist on it.
Oh, yeah.
My being in there 9 to 5 every day.
No, 8 to 6.
only if you insist that
is
we that are
reciprocal?
Only there between 9 and 5.
Yes.
Exactly.
I have a story about that, too. A man was late for work, 7 minutes, and the boss was waiting. He said, you're 7 minutes late. He said, when you were in the service, what did they say when you were late? He says they just stood up, saluted, and said, good morning, Colonel.
He was a boss. Okay, well, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Yes. Yes. So we're after that? Yes.
Listen, Fred, if you're stalling any of these things like this, or that I'm thinking to leave it here, you know, for my view, you don't have, I don't. I wouldn't have mine.
You know, they have already measured it, and they'll keep everything in place until January 20th, and they've got...
Yes.
Okay.
I'll get a
wonderful
picture. Put this down.
You two in the middle.
Three. There's one on the way.
That's what
I
meant.
This two in the middle between you and me.
Okay, right. Well, yeah, I see what you mean. Yeah.
Just a few weeks. We're hoping it will be a Reagan baby.
Right.
Kathleen?
Kathleen.
Look up here.
Hi.
We probably won't get her to smile, but that's okay.
They just get fascinated.
Yeah, she does.
She loves it.
And she doesn't smile. Can you say hello?
There,
she said it.
Tell the president what the horsey says.
She knows what the horsey says. Well, it was a very special event for Kathleen. We wanted to make sure she had a chance to meet you. And these will be very special photos for her in the future.
Thank you, Mr. President.
You
in there of our 100 years, and a dinosaur pop-up book, and a few little goodies, and the bag's kind of nice too, so you can use that.
Thank you very much.
I hope you can use that.
Well, so, thank you. I can.
And I can't tell you how proud I am to serve in your White House and the administration,
well,
and it's been the highlight of our lives.
Sure, well, I appreciate all you've done.
We've enjoyed it.
And you and Mrs. Reagan have a great retirement, a long and happy retirement. You deserve it.
Thank
and a wonderful time out west and on your holiday. Yeah.
We miss California more than anything, I have to tell you.
So, yes.
So, well, we'll let you get back to work, but thank you for taking the time.
Thank you very much. Kathleen, can you say goodbye?
Say bye.
Bye. Say
bye-bye.
Bye. Bye. Thank you very much.
Right. Good luck, Mr. President. Thank you for everything.
She takes after her dad. She's not shy at all.
Sir.
Sir.
Property will be confiscated by the Noriega regime?
Well, all I can tell you is that we continue to be involved in that problem to try to find answers for the things that are happening, and I can't go beyond that.
Lights, please. Thank you.
We're going to have a budget below $1 trillion.
We're going to have a budget that we'll be presenting to the Congress very shortly. And it will be in keeping with the Graham Rudmond program for leading toward a balanced budget.
Thank you very much.
Cameras, display, please.
What we do is start one.
Stay tuned. We're picking up
last. Well, Clayton Yider and Dick Ling and Bill Verity didn't get much sleep while in Canada 2 weeks ago, but their all-night negotiation session and hard work paid off. We achieved agreements in 11 of the 15 areas that were under negotiation and came close on two more. One of the biggest problems remains agricultural reforms, and that issue will be readdressed in April at a continuation of the Montreal meeting. But I've asked Clayton to give you an overview of the negotiations at the Montreal meeting. Now that the remaining linchpin is agriculture, Clayton will have his work cut out for him as Secretary of Agriculture.
From the frying pan to the fire. Well,